Okay, so last week on the channel, we talked a little bit about my sports filmmaking setup and the gear that I will be using in the upcoming year, 2022. Now, this week, I was actually hired by a couple sports teams to film their games. So today, I just want to talk about the settings that I use, how I utilize my gear to its fullest capabilities, and my thought process going into filming sports. Did I just nail it? Okay, well, we'll leave it at that. Let's get into it. But first, I gotta take Murphy for a walk. That's step one of every day. Okay, I just filmed this earlier and I made it way too complicated, so I'm just gonna give you the bare bones recommendation for when you're filming sports. Sports are action-packed, so you're gonna wanna shoot in slow motion, so I recommend using the 180 degree shutter rule and shooting at either 60 or 120 frames per second at your lowest aperture. Typically, that's f2.8 or like f4 or something like that, or if you don't have those, just shoot at the lowest aperture that your lens has. That'll get you that nice depth of field, blurry background, if you will. Personally, I shoot sports somewhere between f2.8 and f4, depending on how fast the movement is. If you're shooting too wide open on your aperture, you lose focus of players sometimes, so remember that. Also, shoot at your native ISO. So for my camera personally, the native ISO when I'm shooting in log is 640. So I typically shoot at 4K, 60 frames per second, ISO 640 at f2.8. So those are my typical settings. Oh, and I shoot in log, so I have color grading capabilities. All right, this is something that I've been working on recently, and that is telling the story of the game. Each video that you should create should have a beginning, middle, end. And it can be super bare bones, but most stories typically have a character. So when I show up to an event, I'm like, I think, who's the team that I'm filming? And then I typically get shots of the logo, the establishing shot of like the venue or location we're at, whether that's a drone shot of a gym or a wide shot at like 24 millimeters of like a basketball court. And then I introduce like the characters. So I do a lot of close-up shots of people's faces. If you know the team, I typically tell them to do like a lot of like pointing and stuff at the camera just because it always looks cool. And then for the middle, that's the game. You know, you gotta get the best highlights you can, put it together, make them look good, even if they just got blown out of the gym. I like getting the celebrations from the benches when someone shoots a three, or the celebrations in hockey when they all jump on each other after a goal. And then the ender, maybe show the teams shaking hands or something like that, like a closing clip. That's a struggle of mine. Sometimes I do not end my videos well, but I think it's easy to skip over story when you're filming sports. Yeah, so that's my thought process when I go into it. Lastly, getting the best out of your camera. I mentioned it in the settings, doing things like shooting at your native ISO, using the correct shutter speeds, making sure that you don't have too shaky footage. So for me, how I film most of my sports. Give me this camera strap, it's in my drawer. Give me a camera strap, I gotta show them. Okay, so I take the camera strap and I put it around my neck and then I hold it tight. This is way too long, but it stabilizes your footage. So that's basically how I film fast-paced sports. Oh, also I use a ProMist filter. This is simply because I enjoy cinematography and making footage look movie-like, but this filter blooms your highlights. So when you're like in a gym or at sunset or anywhere where there's a light, it will bloom the light and make it look nice. I recommend, but also don't steal my style. I think I covered everything. So that's my recipe for filming sports. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments, or if I don't answer your comment here, send me a message on Instagram, which I'll put right here. And thank you for being here. I really do appreciate it. And bye.